Hello, Harpers. Welcome to another episode of Tune Tutor Christmas Edition. Today we're going to be looking at the tune, the ever-popular Greensleeves, which is not just for Christmas. I will have my beginner-friendly, non-levered, lap harp-friendly arrangement of this below in the description. There are actually three different ways that you can get this arrangement, so be sure and click the description box where it says show more and you can find out which one works for you. I'm going to play this for you first, and then today we're going to learn the melody and look at some fingering suggestions. Again, I'm going to show you a couple of easy ways to make this arrangement lap harp friendly. There's only one tiny measure that needs to be changed. I'm going to show you the opening here. So if you have a 22 string that ends on that C and you don't have that A, one quick trick you can do is instead of A E, you can change that to this high A first, and then go to the E. So instead of this, it sounds like this. And the way you do that is just go ahead and first place that A and the E, and then right away place your 4-3-2-1 on A, B, C, E. You can just practice placing that. You could also just do both of those runs in the same octave here. Just do them twice. And then start. So either way works to make this playable on a lap harp. The rest of it will work fine for a 22 string. So let's learn the melody. And the way I have the fingering here is I start with 3 on A. Just go ahead and place 3 on A. You're going to skip B. And your second finger will be on C, and your thumb will be on D. And then we're going to cross under. So as you're playing that D with your thumb, the second finger needs to sneak over here and be ready to pluck the E. And then your thumb can sneak up to the F. So let's back that up a little bit. cross, cross. And now your thumb is ready to play the F. A few different ways you could do this. I find myself going, bringing the thumb to that B. So you could think of this as one bracket where your thumb is on F, second finger's on E, third finger's on D. And then as you play that D, just propel that thumb forward to land on the B. So let's back up. Thumb on B. So all of these phrases can be very connected, and it'll help you from getting lost in the sheet music, and you can concentrate more on the left hand. So I like to play this G with my fourth finger. It's a little tricky, but it helps this next section flow really easily. Just like that. I'm going to play the first chunk altogether just so you can see how it flows. One, four, three, two, one. So, you've learned this part. So now we're on a B. Our fourth finger is going to go to G. And then we're just going to run straight up from G to the C. Next, you'll have your second finger pretty easily reaching the A, so we want to play two A's there. And then your third finger can be right down there, ready to go on the G. So let's just play that phrase. And you'll notice after you played that last A, you can sneak your thumb onto this B. Because we're going to go down in a triad, an E minor triad. So let's just recap what we've done from the beginning. That's the first whole phrase. Third finger's on A to start. We skip the B. Cross under. Thumb's on B now. Four is on G, all the way up. Two, two, three, two, one, two, three. So you can pause that. You can slow this video down in the bottom right corner if you need to. And let's go ahead and move on to the next phrase. Very similar to the first, so start the same way. So that's all the same. All the way when you get up to that 4-3-2-1, up to that C. Here's where it changes. So you've hit that C again. So we're just gonna play around on these A, B, and C strings for the ending there. Just like that. Just fingers 3-2-1. 1-2-3. 2-1-2-3. Now in my arrangement, I don't have you playing that last A because we're taking it a little bit later again in this part. So I'll show you how that goes here. Don't play the A. There it is. Just like that. So that is the verse. At the end, I'm going to play it slowly, just the right hand, so you can play along with me. But for now, let's do the chorus. And I'll have timestamps below in the YouTube comments, so you can just click on that number and jump to where you need to be. Run again. It's very similar to the verse, except we're starting on this high G. So there's an easy way to connect them. if you take your first three fingers, just play this as a bracket, the G, F, and E will be together. And then as you play that E, bring your thumb down to the D. And now you're ready to play a G triad. Backwards, right? So remember, three strings in a row, and then a triad. But again, if you want to take that run with your fourth finger, then it would be best for us to go ahead and play that triad 1, 2, 4, and then your third can easily take the A and go up. 1, 2, 4, 3, 2, 1. And this is just the same as the verse. Here's our E triad. And then we repeat that. 4 here. 4. All right, here's where it changes. And it's exactly the same as the beginning too. So once you've learned the verse, it's very, very similar to the chorus. So we're gonna play the whole thing, just the melody, see if you can play along. We're gonna start, remember, with the third finger on A, skip the B, second finger's on C, first finger is on D. And this has a pickup, so it'll come on the third beat. This is in 3-4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That's how it'll start. So I'll count us in. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Place the triad. Start over. Now play the chorus. Here's our triad, landing on 4. 3, 2, 1, same as before. Land on 4, 3, 2, 1. Great. Thanks so much for learning this tune with me. As always, if you have suggestions for tunes you want to learn, put them in the comments down below. I read all your comments. And be sure and check out the description box to find out how you can get sheet music for this arrangement. If you want to see more tutorials like this one, click right over there. If you want to subscribe, click my face. And thank you, as always, to my patrons for supporting these videos. If you want to find out more about that, you can click up above there. I'll see you next Friday. Bye-bye!